Well, ladies and gentlemen, I am so glad I woke up from my nap because they're starting early today. I sure hope they have their same numbers from last game, too. All right, hang on. I guess I gotta go. I'll be back. So we got one out. Yeah, all right. Hopefully you can hear me. Let me know, please, Lynn. Welcome, folks. Sorry, one away here. I had to go get the lineup from Coach. Taking on Houston Christian here. Let me change the scoreboard. I didn't get a chance to do that because they started early, and I can't find my cursor on my laptop. Come on, there we go. The Houston Christian Mustangs are here on the field. There's two down, runner at first base, no score here in the top of the first inning. Runner goes, throw down to second, not in time. Parham on the mound for the Spartans here today. One ball, one strike, the count here. To number two, that's Frank for the Mustangs. Base hit out to left field. Gets past the left fielder, Moriarty. And run will score. Langford at the plate here. Is it That long strike. Nothing and won the count. The pitch to Lankford. Hit up in the air, straightaway center. Going back forward to Schmidt. Makes the catch. Route number three. Get caught up here. Off here in the bottom half of the first inning. They trail 1-0. Rip to the third baseman. Throw from third. Got him. One down here. Next up, Schmidt, the center fielder. Up to the left side, foul. One ball, one strike. Now the count. The 1-1 pitch. A little number to the shortstop. Just over his head as he trips over the lip. Lets it drop for a base hit. Allen, the shortstop, going back for it, and then just hit the lip. Looking to his counterpart, saying, hey, a little help would be good. Evans, the catcher, comes to the plate. Go, Pitch down the left line. Foul. Strike one. Called strike. Nothing in two now. The count to the catcher, Evans. Swing in the dirt. One away now. Two away. Beg your pardon. Next up, Goldberg. Goldberg playing first base here this game. Pitched the first game this morning. Started at 11 o'clock. Now this one this afternoon. Ball in the dirt. Schmidt hustles down to second on the pass ball. Ripped to the left side, going back over the head. It's going to score a run as Schmidt was on his wheels. And a stand-up double for Goldberg. Two-out rally here for the Spartans. 1-1 the score. Nice job. Ball comes to the plate. Third baseman here this afternoon. Call strike. And unfortunately, don't have the same numbers they did from their white uniforms now to their red. So I'm a little confused. Call strike two. The 0-2 pitch with two away, runner at second base, swing and a miss, got him. One left on, but the score tied. No, 1-1. We'll head to the top of the second inning. This is St. Stephen's Spartan Baseball right here on Vype Live. Michael Rose, Len DeSalvo bringing you the action here this afternoon. Len is our QA back at Vype Live. Appreciate Len being with me, and we're rocking and rolling. We had a good time this morning. Unfortunately, the Mavericks of St. John's defeated the Spartans 9-1. Here we got a 1-1 game, so young men picking up. Here, ready to rock and roll here this afternoon. Top of the second coming your way next. Leading things off here, the top of the second inning for the Mustangs, number 7, Freeman, second baseman. Parham's pitch. Hit up in the air, straightaway center. Schmidt coming in for it. Now has to go back. Wynn took it over his head. Misjudged it. Overran second. Now we got ourselves a pickle going on. Runner's out as he ran out of the baseline trying to avoid. Wow, what a fortuitous turn of events that was. My goodness. Zatopek, the first baseman, comes to the plate for the Mustangs with one away here in the top of the second. Pitch called, strike one. Pitch skips in, ball one, one ball, one strike. Pitch inside, two balls, one strike. Oh, my goodness. A little discussion about what Well, and now the peanut gallery. As well, between the wind and getting hit by a pitch but not being able to take your base and all kinds of jazz, now he can take his base on ball four. My heavens. One away here in the top of the second inning. It's 1-1. Get you all caught up. I had to listen to the mumblings. Couldn't really get an explanation other than he couldn't take his base because he thought he leaned into it. Breaking balls are tough to decipher. At the plate here, number 8, the center fielder Warren for the Mustangs. One on, one out. Top of the first, or excuse me, bottom of the second. What the heck, Michael? Top of the second. I'll dance around it until I finally get it, huh? My goodness. 1-0 pitch to Warren. Ripped to the left side. It's going to drop for a base hit right in front of Moriarty. Runners are first and second, one away. Beyer now, the left fielder at the plate. Parham on the mound and his first pitch to Beyer. Inside, misses ball one. One more pitch, hit up in the air, foul. Parham hustles all the way from the mound as Evans just stands there watching it. He's usually the one that communicates, and he didn't even take his mask off to look for it. Nice hustle by Parham, holy cats. Went almost three times as far for that foul ball as the catcher could have, but oh well. One ball, one strike the count here to the number 9 hitter in the order for the Mustangs, Beyer. Breaking ball inside. Evans sets up, frames it nicely. One ball, two strikes. One, two pitch in the dirt. Two balls, two strikes. Swing and a miss. Got him. Two down now. Back to the top of the order. Henning the DH. I'm not sure what Henning was able to do his first at bat. I apologize. So when I get a chance, I'll ask somebody. First pitch, misses away, one ball, no strikes. Called strike one. Hits the outside part. Parham able to put it right back where he wants it. Pitch off the glove of Evans. Runners will move up to second and third. No play. Two down now. Runners at second and third. Upstairs, 2-1 now. Parham's trying to aim it. Just let it go, buddy. There it is. Hit up in the air. Schmidt going to camp underneath it. He'll make the catch route number 3. What happens in your rear back? Let your defense help you out. Two innings in the books, inning and a half. We'll head to the bottom of the second. 1-1 is the score. This early start's got me all discombobulated. Leading things off here, Parham, the pitcher, in the second inning. First pitch, ball one. Lankford on the bump for the Mustangs. Misses away 2-0. Lankford on the bump, Minton behind home plate. Over at first base is Zapotec, Freeman at second, Henning at third, Allen at shortstop. Byer in left, Warren in center, and Frank out there in right field for the Mustangs. The 2-0 pitch on the way to Parham, called strike one. Followed away, 2 balls, 2 strikes. Count is full here to Parham. Hit to the left side, drops for a base hit. Got some big fans in the stands for Parham right there as he rips a single to lead things off here in the second. Next up is O'Hara, again not wearing the same number as he did in the first game. The heck? Some popped up right side. Second baseman Freeman camps underneath it, makes the out. I believe this is Urban, who is also not wearing the same number as he did in the first game and also not wearing the same uniform as everybody else because his number has got black and white trim around it instead of all white. Interesting, huh? Chopper to third base. It's over to two. Over to first. Double play. Oh, never mind. He didn't make it. I thought he got him. Moriarty now at the plate, the number nine hitter. Urban slides back in safely to first. Two down here, runner at first base for the Spartans. The left fielder Moriarty at the plate. Moriarty showing his skills, even for being small in stature. He definitely can ball. Great athlete in the outfield and had a couple chances in the first game, made some contact, but. Misses inside, 2-0. Pitch misses away, 3-0 now. Time called by Minton. He'll head out to the mound to talk to Lankford a hot second. Tell you folks, took my jacket off because I thought the sun was going to keep me warm, but this wind is cold. Moriarty takes it all the way, 3-1. Moriarty hustles down on a walk. So back to second. Ratliff at the plate, nothing and one. The count here too, Ratliff. Runs at first and second with two away. Pitch misses. One ball, one strike. Got him. Oh, wait. Wow. Urban was sleeping. My gosh. He is a lucky young man to not have been tossed out right there. Nice shot by Minton all the way down. Good communication between him and Allen, the shortstop. Urban was sleeping. My gosh. Wow. Two balls, one strike, the count to Ratliff. Swing and a miss. Evens the count 2-2. Wow. Another swing and a miss. That'll end it. So now I can say two innings complete here at St. Stephen's High School. Michael Rose along with Len DeSalvo. Len, our QA extraordinaire. Myself on lead vocals. We are the dynamic duo here on Vype Live. We'll be back for the third inning after this. This little break, I should say. Leading things off here is Minton, the catcher. Nothing and one the count, and the pitch, swing and a miss, tipped into the glove of Evans, strike two. Jeez, oh Pete. That wind, my gosh, what blew my whole table over. One ball, two strikes now, the count. Whew. Count remains 1-2 after that foul out of play. Pitch in the dirt. Evens the count 2-2. Parham trying to work ahead. Ball ripped out to right field, right into the glove of Urban. Urban took a little step, made the catch, out number one. Allen coming to the plate. Big swing and a miss. Got fooled on that one. Wow. 1-1 the count now to Allen. Shortstop. Little number. Right back to Parham. He throws him out for out number two. Allen didn't even bother to run out of the box. I got in big trouble when I was in high school. I pitched in relief quite a few times, actually. And one time, batter nubbed it right back up to me, and he didn't run, so I just bowled it. I rolled it rolled it over to first. I got chewed out, but man, I love to make people laugh, and that's definitely what I did. I doubt anyone's really that amused, but it's a good memory. Two balls, no strikes. The count here to Frank. Frank singled his first at bat. Left stranded at second. Two and one now the count. Evans couldn't frame that quick enough. Never seen a catcher do so many cute things besides just crouch. He loves to do the splits and set up inside, outside. Now he's on one knee. Ball hit out to center, going back forward to Schmidt. Makes the catch on the move. Nicely done. Three up, three down here for the Mustangs in the third. We'll go to the bottom of the third. Got a 1-1 score here. Heck of a baseball game this afternoon, folks. Thanks for watching Spartan Baseball here on Vype Live. Michael Rose, Len DeSalvo bringing you the action today. Give you the sights and sounds here as they warm up and head into the bottom of the third inning. Time now for the bottom of the third, leading things off for the Spartans is Schmidt, the center fielder. Schmidt singled, scored the only run so far for the Spartans here. Goldberg knocked him in. He'll be up in a couple. Pitch misses away. One ball, actually two balls, no strikes. Pitch misses away. 3-0 now. Schmidt way ahead in the count. Let's see if he has the green light on this one. Called strike one. Which means he does not have the green light on that one. Pitch in the dirt. Schmidt hustles down on a walk here to lead things off in the third for the Spartans. Evans, the catcher, comes to the plate. He's 0 for 1 today. Struck out back in the first. Visit out to the mound, and that's going to do it for Lankford. I see that number 14 here for... That's Henning, the third baseman. Lankford heads to first base. Zapotec heads over to third. Henning comes in relief. Evans now steps into the box here on the right side. He's again, he's 0 for 1 so far today. Runner at first base. Nobody out. Pitch in the dirt. One ball, no strikes. The count here to the catcher, Evans. Way ahead of that one. 1-1 the count. Chop foul, strike two. Breaking ball. Oh. Breaking ball comes in on his helmet. So runners at first and second with nobody out. Goldberg comes to the plate. He's 1 for 1 today. Doubled back in the first. Knocked in the only run. Schmidt and Evans. Schmidt at second, Evans at first for the Spartans here in the bottom of the third inning. Goldberg stepping back from that one instead of right at the pitcher for some reason. Pitch hits the outside corner, strike one. That one followed back to the screen, strike two. Didn't notice his feet before, but he's stepping out instead of up or at the pitcher. Watch that front foot. Nothing in two, the count. Two on, no outs. Throw down to second. Big lead, nice shot. Minns, one heck of a catcher. He's got good vision and good communication out there for the middle infielders. Not sure why our base runners for St. Stephen's are falling asleep so much over there. Pitch right back up the middle. Tough play. Scooped up, throw it on to first. Got the lead runner. But the runners are able to move up to second and third. Now one away. Good hustle by Allen, the shortstop, making the play. Ball now, the third baseman for the plate. Struck out his first at bat. He's 0 for 1. Big cut for ball. Ball popped up. Zapotec able to make the catch in foul territory, going backwards, route number two. Parham now comes to the plate. Chopper right back up front, picked up, throw it on to first, got the lead runner and the out. Tough play for Henning, and he gets the play. Two left on. Henning comes on in relief. After two get on, he gets the next three. No harm, no foul, 1-1 after three complete. We'll go to the top of the fourth here. Michael Rose along with Len DeSalvo right here in Vype Live at St. Stephen's Baseball from St. Stephen's Episcopal School here in Austin, Texas. Things seem to be settling down here as we get to the top half of the fourth inning. Update the scoreboard here. Leading things off for the Mustangs is the now first baseman, Lankford. Well, 1-0 the count here to Lankford. Lankford 0 for 1 today, flew out to center his first at bat. This pitch going down the left side, hook and foul, it's foul. 1-1 now the count to Lankford. Parham on the mound. Over there at first base is Goldberg. At second is O'Hara. Over at third is Ball. This one ripped to left field into the gap. It's going to drop all the way to the fence. It rolls. Moriarty picks it up. He'll throw it in. Bobbles the throw, and he'll be able to slide in safely at third base. Ball knocks it down. But a leadoff triple here for Lankford and the Mustangs in the fourth inning. Moonshot of sorts. Moriarty hit Ratliff the tag for the cutoff. But Ratliff could not hang on to it to make the play at third. This ball hit up. Jeez Louise. Foul ball, and Freeman just whips his bat behind the backstop. Yeah, I think you can tell how hard he swung at that one. Freeman ripped one. A base hit back in the actually reached on air, and the ball gets past him. Runner's going to score. Two to one now as Lankford comes across the plate on a wild pitch by Parham. 2-1. Pitch in the dirt, 3-1. To Freeman. Anyway, Freeman was, I was just going to say, he's got caught in the rundown, in the pickle. There's, he overshot second. Couldn't put the brakes on as he rounded second, I should say. First question out of coach's mouth is to Parham is, how you doing? And he's going to give him a break as his time is done. Parham will move over to third. Ball will jump on the mound. Take a little break here. Let Ball warm up. All right, ball is all set here as he gets warmed up. I was just going to say, watching ball warm up, that high leg kick, I'm betting that Lankford's first move is going to be, or excuse me. Freeman's first move is going to be to steal second.
All right, Warren, let's go, bud.
Now there's a no-doubter as Zapotec gets hit by a pitch again, but this time they'll give him his base. Runners at first and second, no outs here in the top half of the fourth inning. One run's already come across. Lankford tripled and scored on a wild pitch. Now Warren at the plate, he's one for one, singled back in the first, excuse me, in the second inning. One ball, no strikes. In the dirt, gets away from Evans, but he's able to knock it down, keep it in front of him. Just enough to keep everybody where they're at. Runners at first and second, no outs. Center fielder Warren at the plate. Three balls, no strikes, the count. This one loads the bases. Byer at the plate, struck out his first at bat. Oh, beg your pardon, BR. Just heard someone say that, so. Either that's how you really pronounce it or that's just the nickname they gave him. I don't know, but we're going to go with it, BR. It sounds kind of fun. There we go. Finally, give him his rhythm. Two balls, one strike now. Good job by Evans keeping his position. Setting up on the inside, holding it right over that inside corner. Got the strike call. The pitch. Dribbler to the left side. Foul just on the other side of the bag. Count even. I beg your pardon now. One ball, two strikes. Ball for the Spartans needs to help himself right here in this 1-2 pitch. Corner's way up into the grass, especially on the left side. Pitch upstairs. Now it's 2-2. Goldberg right on the edge of the grass over there at third. Ratliff at regular depth, along with O'Hara, both at regular depth. Not sure why, but they are. Pitch upstairs, fills the count, 3-2. At least be even with the bag if I was. Fisted up in the air. Parr makes the catch as BR pops up one away here. Back to the top of the order here. Henning comes to the plate. There's a Henning who pitches and a Henning who DHs, and this is the DH, obviously. I don't have first names, just initials. It'd be M. Henning at the plate. J. Henning is the pitcher. Pitch. This one hit foul out of play. Nothing and one the count now with one away and bases loaded. The Mustangs up 2-1 here in the top half of the fourth inning. Scored their second run earlier on a triple and a wild pitch by Langford, who's now at first base. Pitch inside, misses. 1-1 now the count. Foul tip into the glove, strike two. Bases loaded, one away. Henning calls timeout. Steps out of the box, now he'll get back in. The tall, lanky left-hander in the batter's box. The 1-2 pitch ripped all the way down the right field line, but foul into the corner. Count remains 1-2. Again, I want to give a shout-out to Len DeSalvo, our QA back at Vype Lab Studios. He's hanging out with me today. We had our game one earlier today at 11 o'clock start. This one was supposed to start at 3, but they got the jump on us. Good thing I literally woke up from my nap over in my car. Figured I'd just hang out and get over here leisurely, get things started at 3 o'clock, but they got to start early. Pitch away, evens the count, 2-2. One lace to right field. It'll drop for a base hit. One run scores. RBI and a base hit for Henning. 3-1 now is the score here at St. Stephen's. That's just the second hit today in this inning. First pitch popped up just over our heads, out of play. Strike one here to Minton, the catcher. Minton today is 1-2. Had a base hit back in the first and scored a run. A line drive rip right to Urban in right field, his second at bat. So no problem making contact for this young man. Pitch away, one ball, one strike. One ball, one strike, the count. This one gets away, but Evans slides out to stop it. 2-1 now the count. Change that scoreboard before I forget. 3-1 is the score. Pitch away, 3-1. Evans set up outside. Minton saw him moving. Let that one go. 3-1 now the count. Swing and a miss. Fills the count. 3 balls, 2 strikes. Bases loaded, one out here in the top half of the fourth inning. 2 runs have come across on 2 hits for the Houston Christian Mustangs. 1 hit up in the air over to the left side. Parham there, juggles it. Two outs. So there's two outs, and I think we're just going to let this go. This one's hit up in the air, out to left. Moriarty makes the catch out in left to end the inning. Wow. Interesting. That's all I can say. Interesting. 3-1. The end of 3.5. We're head here to the bottom of the fourth inning. Spartans will come to the plate trailing 3-1. You're watching Spartans Baseball right here on Vype Live. Take a little break, let you listen to the music, watch a warm up, and we'll be back for the bottom of the fourth after this. Well, we're going to get here to the bottom of the fourth inning. I'll change the scoreboard, but there's still lots of discussion going on, and rightly so, between the umpires and the coaches, because whatever happened. I mean, that's cute every once in a while, but. That's not necessary. That's what happens when parents get to run the scoreboard and the music. Anyways, it's funny sometimes, but just trying to get things squared on. That's good. I understand that. Henning's pitch inside. One ball, no strikes count as we get started here in the bottom half of the fourth inning. Leading things off is Goldberg. I beg your pardon. That's O'Hara. Sorry. Numbers are mixing me up. Goldberg was 28 this morning on the white uniform, and I just saw the 8 real fast, but that's 18. That's O'Hara, who I believe he was 10, if not maybe number 4. I can't remember earlier. That one gets away. Two balls, one strike, the count now to O'Hara, second baseman for the Spartans. Mm-hmm.
3-1 now the count. Pitch misses and ball four is the call. O'Hara leads things off. He's 0-for-1 today. Now on board with this walk to lead things off in the fourth. Urban comes to the plate. He reached on the fielder's choice, was left stranded back in the second. Big swing and a miss. Strike one to Urban. Dribbler left side, scooped up, throw it on to second, out number one, over to second, over to first for the double play. Five, four, three, double play. Ball back to the screen, strike one. Moriarty at the plate with two away. Two balls, one strike, the count. A much smaller strike zone here for Moriarty compared to everybody else. This one dribbled right side, foul. Two balls, two strikes, the count now. Pitch from Henning. Hit up in the air to center. Warren makes the catch for out number three. 1-2-3 go. The Spartans here in the fourth, ahead of the top of the fifth. Mustangs leading 3-1. It's the Spartans baseball here on Vype Live. Michael Rose and the legendary Len DeSalvo. We'll be back in just a minute. Leading things off here in the top half of the fifth inning is Frank, the right fielder. Frank so far today 1-for-2. Single back in the first, flew out to center field back in the third. The pitch in the dirt, 2-0, now the count. in the dirt, 3-0 now. Ball having a tough time making things stick here and finding his zone, finding his groove, I should say. Four straight pitches and a walk issued to Frank to lead things off here in the top of the fifth for the Mustangs. Next up is Lankford, the first baseman. Called strike. Good move by Ball. Doesn't throw over, however. Lankford today is 1-for-2. Tripled, scored a run back in the fourth. Throw down to first by Evans. Not in time. One ball, one strike. The count here to Lankford. Called strike two on the outside part. One ball, two strikes now. The count to Lankford. Off the fist, out to left field. Moriarty going back, way back. Makes the catch on what would be, if there was a warning track, he's right next to the fence. That young man with those little legs moves quick. Big, big play right there. One away here in the fifth. Freeman at the plate, walked and scored a run. Runner steals second. Freeman reached on a walk, scored a run back in the fourth. One ball, one strike. Now two Freeman. Runner at second, one away here in the top half of the fifth inning. The Mustangs from Houston Christian leading 3-1. Pitch away. Actually in, I should say. Two balls, one strike. Pitch upstairs, three balls, one strike. Now the count. Ball still having trouble with that location. Another walk issued by Ball. Second of the inning. Two on, one out. Zapotec now comes to the plate. Zapotec walked and hit by pitch. He's yet to record an at-bat here tonight. Pitch upstairs, one ball. Oh, now he calls it. Late call. Nothing and one the count. Ball ripped out to center. Schmidt going back over his head. Runners being waved around. One will score. The other one coming right behind him. Zapotec rips a double all the way out to the fence. Straight away center field. F- 5-1 now the score. Those two walks issued by Ball. Next up for the Mustangs is Warren. This one hit out into right field. Urban can't make the catch. Runner will move up to third from second. Now, since everyone was falling asleep, Zapotec rounds and scores the sixth run of the game, third of the inning. BR at the plate now with one on and one out. Popped up to the right, excuse me, left side. Parham over there makes the catch for out number two. Second time he's popped up to Parham in a row. Two down now. Back to the top of the order. Here's Henning. Henning today is 1 for 3. Ripped a single back in the fourth, left stranded it. That's second. One ball, no strikes to count to Henning. Ball tip into the glove. One ball, one strike. Just got around the tag. Did Warren at third on the steal. Runner at third base, two away here in the top half of the fifth inning. Change the scoreboard to reflect the real score, 6-1. Follow back to the screen here in front of me. Two to the count. Pitch away, fills the count 3-2. Yeah, Lynn DeSalvo or QA back at Vype Lab just letting me know or reminding me the fifth inning has been the death of the Spartans. They gave up 6 runs back in the fifth inning this morning's game against St. John's, losing 9-1. And Ball issues yet another walk this inning. I believe that's number 3 so far in this inning alone. This is the 8th batter coming up. It's Minton, the catcher. Minton's 1 for 3 today. Reached on a fielder's choice back in the 4th inning. Runner goes. Defensive indifference as Evans just lets him go. One ball, no strikes to count for the catcher, Minton, for the Mustangs. Runners now at 2nd and 3rd with 2 outs. The pitch, called strike, nice shot. Good movement, good action right there for Ball getting the strike. Two balls, two strikes, the count now. Ball ripped to the right side, foul. Count remains 2-2. Ball steps off. Thought about going to third as he hears the taunts from Warren over there at third base. Pitch away, fills the count, 3-2. Ball just missing. Pitch misses. Now the base is loaded once again. Allen comes to the plate. The number 9 batter here in this inning. Evans goes to his knees, knocks that ball down. One ball, no strikes. Good job by the catcher to keep things in front of him. Bases loaded here. Two outs. Three runs have come across here in this fifth inning. One, two, four walks issued. Ripped down the left side. Coach drops to his bottom, getting out of the way. Evens the count. One ball, one strike as it goes foul. Breaking ball way upstairs. Ball goes to the backstop. Another run comes across. Foul. Frank led things off with a walk and scored the first run here in this fifth inning. Nothing and two, the count to Allen. Allen 0 for 3 today. Ball rip foul right between the legs of the coach sitting on the bucket of balls. Count remains nothing and two. Ball ripped out into left center. Schmidt comes up with it. Two more runs come across. Yeah, six more runs here this inning. It's now 9. Nine to one. Deja vu all over again, Lynn. Unfortunate here for our Spartans. Runner goes, throw down to second. Nobody there, and runner comes across to score the 10th run. Runners move up. Lankford flew out to get the first out of this inning. Now he's at the plate with runner at third and two outs. 10-1 is the score here. Evans knocks that one down. Two balls, no strikes. Called strike, 2-1 now. Pitch inside, walks him. Runners at the corners, two outs. Time called by coach here for the Spartans. Now he'll take it away. Infield comes in. Ratliff will take it. Ball will go back to third. Parham will go to second. O'Hara will go. Whoops. O'Hara will go to shortstop. Ten to one is the score here at St. Stephen's High School. Ratliff on the mound here in relief for the Spartans. His first pitch called strike 2. Freeman. Freeman walked and scored a run earlier this inning. Got him. Blocked the plate. Got the runner. Frank tried to sneak home. Couldn't do it. Freeman will come back to try it again. Finally, the Spartans able to get out of the top half of the fifth inning. It's 10-1. Big road ahead of them here as they come to bat here in the bottom of the fifth right after this.
Seven.
Yeah.
You're earning your money today, huh?
Yeah, I think so.
Fifth inning got him the first game, too. The fifth inning the first game got him, too. They let six go in the fifth inning the first game. Yeah.
Ratliff now the pitcher, starting things off here in the bottom half of the fifth inning. Let's change that inning to reflect the bottom of the fifth. Chopper, throw over to first, got him. Zapotec with the big arm from third base over to Langford at first, got the out. Schmidt, the center fielder, coming to the plate. Yeah, it's a tough road to hoe. The fifth inning, first game, fifth inning, this game, combined 13 runs given up by the Spartans. Michael Rose along with Linda Salvo here at St. Stephen's High School. 10-1 the score. Strike two the call. 1-2 now the count to Schmidt, the center fielder. One away here in the bottom of the fifth inning. Pitch inside, evens the count 2-2. Reaches out for that one, just gets past the pitcher. Slow roller on to first. Safe. Nice wheels by Schmidt. Booking it down the line. This one hit over the head, straightaway center. Schmidt on his horse, round and second. Evans, stand up triple. literally stripping himself. It's Evans. How many Velcro straps does one baseball player need to have on their body at one time? Big rip. Goldberg at the plate now tonight. He is 1-for-2, a double back in the first, ground out back in the third. Runner at third, chopper. Tagged out. What is he doing out of? The play was at the plate. No, you don't. No, you do not. I'm sorry. You do not need to give a lane to the runner. You need to block the plate just like you did. Mitten makes a block at the plate, gets the out. Goldberg reaches on a fielder's choice. Two down here. No, they, ma'am, please stop. Evans got a little chirpy, and Blue just came up to tell me that I'm sure you heard it. Two outs, still in the game, not being asked to leave, which is good. Goldberg over there at first base, one on, two outs here in the fifth. Ball at the plate. First pitch misses low, skips in, one ball, no strikes. Holy cats. Henning on his horse. Minton didn't see it, but you saw that. That was amazing. Good hustle, young man. Ball pops up for out number three. Ugh. Ratliff at the plate.
Coach?
you. Thank you. Appreciate it.
William Schmidt in the game at catcher. Ball hit up in the air out to left center, and it's going to drop for a base hit on his horse. Running in to second on a double is Freeman. Excuse me, 22 is Ainsworth. Thank you for 16. Freeman goes back to second. Oh my gracious. All kinds of miscommunication on that one. That's too bad. Pop up. Goldberg makes the catch. Out number one. Ainsworth pops out in pinch hitting style. Warren at the plate. Warren tonight, 1-for-3. Ball hit up in the air. Moriarty in center now. Camps underneath it, makes the catch. Runner tags, heads up to third, two away now. Double play as he didn't tag up. So, I didn't change the scoreboard. I apologize. That was the top of the sixth. I'm just going to put it in there so you can see it. Just so Merle Bertrand can see that I actually, you know, as we go back and look at the archives here. My goodness sakes. This laptop, my friends, it's a little bit to be desired sometimes. But I'm grateful for it. Well, at the bottom of the sixth inning, 10-2 the score. I need to update that scoreboard. It's I didn't get Schmidt's run come across back there in the fifth. Nonetheless, here we go. Parm due up here to lead things off in the sixth inning for the Spartans. Minton from his knees, throw down. Yes, bomb six, yes, sir. Parham puts it up in the air over to the left side. It's going to drop into the glove, unfortunately, of Maury. Of Biar. O'Hara coming to the plate now. Henning shot. Misses away. One ball, no strikes. Short hop by Allen, the shortstop. Throw on to first base to Langford. Got him for out number two. Two down now. Urban comes to the plate. Called strike one. Ball hit up in the air over to the right side, right center. Center fielder coming in. Makes the catch. That was hilarious. Did you see that, Len? Did you see that, y'all? Warren makes the catch in center, keeps the baseball all the way into the dugout, and poor Ratliff just like, can someone give me the baseball, please? Thank you. Oh, man, that's hilarious. You must do that a lot in practice or something. the inning updated. Bottom, sorry, top seven. Leading things off here in the top half of the seventh inning, the number nine slot, the pinch hitter, that's McAllister at the plate. 2-1, the count. That one misses, now it's 3-1. Ratliff, the pitcher for the Spartans. Ooh. McAllister thought that was a little bit sketchy. A called strike nonetheless, even as a count 2-2. I beg your pardon. That darn scoreboard still got me messed up. Foul out of plate. The opposite side of where my vehicle is parked, thank goodness. 10-2 the score here, top seven. Houston Christian Mustangs at the plate. Pinch hitter, the number nine slot. It's McAllister. Little high cheese, rips that one out into center. Moriarty there for the catch and the first out. Top of the order now. Henning comes to the plate. Whew. Pitch upstairs, 1-0, a count. 2, Henning. Dead ball, hit by pitch. Catcher Minton now comes to the plate. Pitch skips in, gets away from Schmidt. Second hit by pitch. Ratliff losing his grip right there. Back-to-back HBPs here. 2-1, 1-out. Allen, the shortstop, steps into the batter's box. Allen tonight. 0 for 3 and a walk. Scored a run back in the fifth. One of the 7 runs scored in the fifth inning. Ball. High cheese hit up in the air. Moriarty camping underneath it. Makes the catch for out number 2. Throws it in to absolutely no one. Goldberg comes in, scoops it up, tosses it over to Ratliff for the next at-bat, which is going to be Frank. Let me be frank with you. Frank tonight is 2 for 3 and a walk. Scored a run back in the fifth. Ratliff steps off, fakes the throw. This one fisted high over to the left side. Ball couldn't make the catch over there. Had some space, just
Couldn't get the couldn't track it well enough. Nothing and one, the count now to Frank. Two on, two out here in the top of the seventh inning. Pitch upstairs, evens the count 1-1. That's wonderful. Pitch misses, 2-1 now. The two men aboard, both were hit by a pitch. Pitch inside, 3-1. Ratliff trying to trying to aim it. He lets that one go a little bit. Swing and a foul tip off the tootsie. Oh, Frank fills the count 3-2. Oh, it's off the inside part of the ankle there. He's going to walk it off. Blue checks on him for a second. Count is full. 2-2 here for the Spartans. Defensively speaking, 2-2 for the Mustangs. Pitch misses inside. Another walk fills the bases. Langford at the plate. First baseman tonight is 1-3 and a walk. Rips this one out into all three runs come across on that stand-up double. Whew. Wowzers. Bases clearing double. Makes it 13-2. Ball gets away from Schmidt on the one hopper from Ratliff. Ripped down the left side, foul. 2-1. That one popped up, left side. Ball makes the catch, route number 3. We'll head here to the bottom of the seventh inning. One more try here for your Spartans. Michael Rose along Len DeSalvo. 13-2 the score.
Seven. This is it. Yep.
Moriarty top here for the... Coming in, Zapotec makes the catch. Moriarty down. On that little pop-up. Ratliff rips a single. Little pop out right there. That's a new left fielder. This is Ben Hale. Now up is the catcher, Schmidt. Pitch gets away. Ratliff moves up. Two balls, one strike to count here to Schmidt. Two outs here in the bottom of the seventh. Hit foul. Count now 2-2. Full count now to Schmidt. The 3-2 pitch. Flails at that one, strike three, and that's the ball game, folks. Final score here for tip of the hat from Austin to Houston. Michael Rose, Len DeSalvo, our QA back at Vype Live Studio. Brought you two games here today at beautiful St. Stephen's High School. Thank you so much for being a part of it. Thank you again to Merle Bertrand, Asuna Van Kant, Christina Weber, all the folks with Vype Live. Appreciate everybody's hospitality. Thank you to all the folks here at St. Stephen's for bringing Vype Live aboard here to bring you these games this afternoon. Tough, tough outings here for the St. Stephen's Spartans, but lots of great learning opportunities. Safe travels back home for the folks from Houston. And again, thank you to everybody involved. Appreciate everyone who made this broadcast possible. Again, thanks to Len, thanks to Merle, thanks to Suna, thank you, Christina. For everybody here for St. Stephen's and Vype Live, my name is Michael Rose. Appreciate you being a part of the broadcast today. Y'all have a blessed weekend. Remember to love your neighbor as yourself. Take good care of each other. Stay well, and God bless.